It is very weird.
Something made a noise over here yesterday, like it fell off of a rack or something. Uh-huh. And then this morning when I went to do it, my one thing wasn't plugged in anymore. I hope I'm not putting battery on my other stuff.
The Paul W. Smith Show, News Talk 760 WJR.
Good Thursday morning to you. It is the 23rd day of July, the 205th day of 2020. There are 161 days left in the year. Make each and every day count. Each day is a gift. We've got the team together here. Dick Hafner, thanks for the news as it was meant to be presented. We appreciate that very, very much. Dick is our WJR news director. He starts our day off with all the news and information we need. Dana Clark is helping out, taking a look at the roadways, the weather information. How's the weather going to be? Good?
Another it's going to be great day. Today. Yes, great, it's going to be day. Dry in the lower 80s, less humid.
All right. That sounds very good. Yes. Like that a lot. We have Brian Morton back in the Golden Tower of the Fisher Building, pressing all the right buttons, or at least we hope he does. And Kim is still toes up, as Judy Coy used to say. Kim is toes up in bed. And, of course, always always working, our executive producer, Ann Thomas.
Good morning, Tom. Happy Thursday.
Happy Friday Eve to you. Friday Eve, indeed. Well, I wish we were starting with all good news, but it's never good news. Once again, we have kids being killed. This time a 10-year-old with now a 15-year-old in custody for the shooting death of the 10-year-old.
What the heck happened there? What are the details on that?
I don't know, but...
Bunch of kids in the apartment there in Warren.
Alone.
They were alone, right. And so somebody came in with a gun. One of the kids came in with a gun, and then the shooting occurred. That's basically what we know so far.
Maybe there'll be some demonstrations regarding kids being killed in the neighborhood.
Maybe so.
Hey, did anyone notice I got a haircut and my beard trimmed?
Oh, Shazzy. You look very nice.
Professionally trimmed by Ginny, haircutter to the stars on the hill. What a good location. The salon is called Salon 76. How's that for a radio station with 760?
Perfect for you.
Salon 76 at 76 Kercheval. So I'll always be able to find it. But yeah,
how was the experience? Give us details.
It's very odd to sit in a barber's chair, basically, even though it's a salon, quote unquote, and look at yourself with a mask on while the haircutter has to cut around the mask. So you take the ear thing off and you hold the mask up with your finger, and you know,
it's a process, huh?
It is a definite process. You know, you haven't lived until your head's back in the bowl getting your hair washed with a mask on.
Yeah.
And looking up at a person with a mask. It is the new temporary reality, I guess. At least I was able to get out and get a haircut.
And it sounds safe. You were safe.
Yeah. I mean, we practiced all the safe hair. It is almost 5:43 at WJR.
This report is sponsored by the podcast, The Daily Zeitgeist.
The Daily Zeitgeist is a podcast from the world's smartest and funniest comics and writers. It gets you caught up on the day's news without grinding you down. Twice a day, they discuss all you need to know without crushing your soul. Listen to The Daily Zeitgeist wherever you listen to podcasts.
And at 5:43, we're checking it for you, our WJR traffic and weather. First, Miss Dana Clark.
Traffic also sponsored by North Bloomfield Properties. If you're looking for a place to call home, let North Bloomfield Properties find the best place for you and your family. They also provide pre-screened quality tenants to their property owners. They love to match good people to good homes. Contact them today, northbloomfield.com. Roadways off to a great start this Thursday, accident-free, no delays. A heads up on some upcoming construction. This is going to kick off on Friday, 11 p.m. All lanes closed in both directions along 75, both directions between 8 Mile and Square Lake Road until 5 a.m. on Monday. Woodward can be used as an alternate. Now, WJR weather first from the Weather Channel, sponsored by Parkway Chrysler Dodge Jeep Ram. Attention new car buyers, Parkway Chrysler Dodge Jeep Ram is offering exclusive lease savings on its entire inventory of new Jeep Compasses, Cherokees, and Grand Cherokees during the Jeep Summer Clearance event. Parkway Chrysler Dodge Jeep Ram, Hall Road in Clinton Township. Just show up, sign up, and ride.
Mix of clouds and sunshine here today. Seasonably warm, light northwest breeze. Mid-80s this afternoon, mid-60s tonight. Sunny skies Friday. Highs tomorrow in the low to mid-80s. Over the weekend, sunny and warmer. Mid-upper 80s on Saturday, back to around 90 Sunday. From the Weather Channel, I'm meteorologist Ken Boone on News Talk 760 WJR.
Thanks, Kenny. 5:44, 16 minutes away from 6 on this Thursday morning edition of the Paul W. Smith Show. We've got the team all together. And joining us, Rush Limbaugh.
Last week, Speaker Nancy Pelosi continued her pander campaign to show solidarity with rioters vandalizing statues in blue cities throughout America. She called for all Confederate statues to be removed from the Capitol grounds. Now, California Democrat Barbara Lee teamed up with Mississippi Democrat Bernie Thompson on a House bill to banish the relics of the Confederacy back to their original states within 120 days. New Jersey Democrat Cory Spartacus Booker introduced a Senate bill seeking to do the same thing. Now, these Democrats are trying to erase the history of their own party. The Confederate statues come from states then controlled by Democrats. It's the Democrat Party that gave America the Confederacy, the KKK, state-sponsored segregation, and Jim Crow. But one of these Confederate statues should get a new home up north. Now standing in Statuary Hall is the likeness of Uriah Milton Rose, a lawyer who was fiercely loyal to the Confederacy. In 1865 in Little Rock, Arkansas, Uriah Rose founded the Rose Law Firm. Many Clinton administration notables worked there at the Rose Law Firm, including Hillary herself. Now, instead of sending old Uriah to collect dust in some warehouse, his white stone statue ought to be sent to the Clinton's estate in Chappaqua and sit dead center right there on the front lawn as a constant reminder of Democrat history.
Rush Limbaugh, noon to 3, today, right here on WJR. All righty.
So, Dub, did you see this story about laced cocaine possibly being an issue in the Grosse Pointe?
Yeah, I saw that yesterday.
What are they talking about?
They're talking about dirty drugs, I guess. I don't think too much about it because I don't get involved in drugs. So right. If you're foolish enough to get involved with cocaine, you're going to possibly be involved with cocaine that's been cut with additional bad stuff. I didn't even go in deeply into the story.
Yeah.
But it's fentanyl, huh? Fentanyl, which is a killer in itself. I wonder why.
Even if somebody just touches fentanyl, you can have a huge problem.
Yeah. It's just bad. If you're going to mess with illegal drugs, you better be ready to mess with things that are not pharmaceutically correct. I mean, this is not, you're not getting this stuff. You're getting it out of some guy's trunk.
Mm-hmm.
And it's just bad and wrong and stupid. And what else can I say? Nobody's going to go and say, hey, you killed my relative when they bought cocaine from you. It was cut with another illegal drug.
Well, according to this article, the DEA says that it's a huge problem in the Midwest. Yeah. That fentanyl-laced drugs is a big issue here.
I'm sure it is.
No, that's not good.
I feel very sorry for the drug addicts who are affected by that.
Yeah, it's not good.
I would suggest not doing drugs, is what my suggestion would be. Yeah. I know that probably is a little bit much to ask of people, but that's what I would think. This Tlaib versus Jones on the front page of the Detroit News.
I see that.
That's getting some national play. I noticed it in either the New York Times, which I despise, or USA Today. I can't remember where I saw it, but I cut it out and then I never did anything with it. It was there the other day.
That's a heated race. Very, very interesting race.
Oregon's very dark history fuels protests in Portland. What was Oregon's very dark history? Anybody?
Don't know. Let's see.
I always thought Oregon was supposed to be an ideal place to live, making great Pinot Noir wine.
Ooh, let's go there. Did you see my story for our chat this morning about chocolate?
Yes, I have it right on top. I didn't want to use it until we were talking to everybody, but
I think we should just.
You're hearing the Paul W. Smith Show, News Talk 760, WJR.
We continue on this Thursday morning, July 23rd, at just about 5:50, 10 minutes away from 6 o'clock. So I said to Kim, after seeing this story that Ann sent along, it is such an old story, I feel ridiculous talking about it.
Oh.
This is not the first time we've talked about dark chocolate being good for you. We've
talked about it enough.
Well, you can't talk about it enough. So I said, honey, do we have any dark chocolate around? She goes, no, I think I purged from all those things, purged our cupboards of all those things. So we have no dark chocolate in the house, even though there's yet another story that says enjoy it because it's good for you. It's keeping the heart's blood vessels healthy. Again, we've heard this about dark chocolate in the past. It is just a reaffirmation that you should live a little. Especially these days, you should live a little and enjoy some dark chocolate once in a while.
Mm-hmm.
Yep. Not only is it not going to hurt you, it's actually supposed to be quite good for you.
And before they change their minds, because this week
it's one they've stayed pretty consistent on the dark chocolate thing. Red wine, the dark chocolate with the flavonoids and all that, they've pretty much stayed consistent with that. They go back and forth. Coffee has been very good for you, then not very good for you. But it's winning on the very good for you also. Coffee is there. And it doesn't matter what they say. I couldn't exist at this hour without coffee. Mm-hmm. It's just the way it is.
We'd be in trouble.
Yeah, big trouble. Did you see that our governor, our nationally known governor, even though it looks like she's no longer in line for the vice presidential pick, did anyone else hear that? Did anyone else hear a voice?
She never was. Okay,
actually,
go ahead.
They say she still is in line.
She's not.
There's a story this week says.
Don't hold your breath.
Still being.
Go ahead, Paul W.
Yeah. Well. So as I was saying before, I was
rudely interrupted.
Yeah, I wasn't going to say rudely interrupted, but since you said it. But since you said it, Governor Whitmer has written an op-ed or letter to the editor that's appearing in the New York Times.
Mm-hmm.
Gretchen Whitmer, what if Trump made everyone wear masks? She starts off with Dateline Lansing, Michigan. My state was hit hard by COVID-19. For many weeks, we had the nation's third highest number of deaths, despite having only the 10th largest population. As a result, we took some of the most aggressive measures in the country in the fight against the disease, and our hard work paid off. Our actions saved thousands of lives. She goes from there, and she talks about masks. She does say that finally the president is wearing a mask, said it was patriotic to wear a mask, but she's pushing. And the push, of course, is to make it a federal mandate that people have to wear a mask. You don't have to ask me. I've always been, long before they were, and even when they were telling me I was wrong, I've been a mask advocate. I believe people should wear masks. for the simple fact that there's a strong possibility that if everybody wore a mask for 2 weeks, mm-hmm. 2 weeks, washed their hands often, physically distanced, wore a mask, we could kill the virus. The virus needs us to live.
You know who else is pushing for the mask big time? The NFL.
Oh, good.
Yes. The NFL says that they would love to have some fans in the stands and they would wear a mask. It won't be at full capacity, but wouldn't that be great if we could have football?
Yeah.
That would be a really good thing.
They decided on no preseason games. Yeah. Well, baseball kicks off tonight.
Mark my words.
Yeah.
What's that, Dick?
Dick, football will require masks. There's no
doubt. Yeah. Everybody should require masks in those situations. There's no question about it. I've been asked to go to a Tiger game. I didn't think we could go to a Tiger game.
Oh, they're pulling your leg. A Tiger game.
No, they asked if I was available a certain date.
Really?
And I don't remember who the game was. It doesn't matter who they're playing to me. I mean, I'd just love to see them. But and I said, I didn't think we could go to Tiger games.
But isn't that because some of the suites might be open?
Oh, maybe. Oh, really?
It's possible. Yeah, I don't know.
It was to a suite. Money so maybe.
Maybe
the mask.
To be of the elevated wealthy class, as I clearly am by being invited. So that'll be interesting. I don't know what I don't even know if that was a done deal. They just asked if I was available on a few dates. How about this? That someone could actually believe that there is a hitman website. Did you see that story of the Michigan woman arrested for murder for hire plot to kill her ex-husband using a fake hitman website? It's called rentahitman.com.
Just Google it on up.
Clever.
It was set up as a joke by some guy. And he went back to it and found a whole bunch of people who had contacted the website wanting the services of the Rent-A-Hitman.
Wow.
And one of them was so specific and so wanted it so badly that he actually called the police and said, look, you better look into this.
Yeah.
This woman from Monroe County is trying to hire a hitman for her ex-husband. And she was willing to spend $5,000 and she filled out... You had to fill out paperwork, a form on this website for Rent a Hitman, and she believed it, hook, line, and sinker.
Wow.
And this is, by the way, this is her ex-husband. So it's not like, like the woman who killed her husband the other day, woman who killed husband may be paroled. You know, it's interesting when someone writes a story. Again, this goes back to Dick Hafner presenting the news the way it's supposed to be presented as news, not opinion. Here's the opinion of the writer of this story, because it starts off this way. After more than a year in prison, Tina Talbot may be coming home this fall. This is a woman who killed her husband. She may have had good reason to do it, but you know where the writer stands when she goes, after more than a year in prison. Now, if the writer were against this person, they would say, after only a year in prison, someone is coming home. You see how it is? It's not even subtle, but it is for some people. After more than a year in prison means she thinks this woman should get out. After only a year in prison, that means she thinks they shouldn't get out. And if they wrote it the way it should be written, it would be after a year in prison, so-and-so is about to get out. Because they were, sentenced to 20 years. But that woman and the woman who... That woman who used the murder for hire plot, she'll get a slap on the back of the hand. You can always see how these things are going. It is, but I mean, you got to get points off for stupidity. I better be careful. She might go back to that rent a hitman and go after me. It is 557 at WJR.
This report is sponsored by the podcast, The Daily Zeitgeist.
The Daily Zeitgeist is a podcast from the world's smartest and funniest comics and writers. It gets you caught up on the day's news without grinding you down. Twice a day, they discuss all you need to know without crushing your soul. Listen to The Daily Zeitgeist wherever you listen to podcasts.
All righty, let's check it here at 5:58, 2 minutes away from 6 o'clock. Our UJR traffic and weather first, Miss Dana.
Traffic First, also sponsored by Gordon Chevrolet. Gordon Chevrolet, where you pick out the vehicle you would love to drive and receive a worksheet with 18 different purchase and lease payments for you to choose from. You do this from the comfort of their outdoor showroom and covered patio seating. Gordon Chevrolet on Ford Road, just west of Merriman in Garden City. GordonChevrolet.com. Gordon Chevrolet, find new roads. Roadways off to a great start this Thursday. Accident free, no delays. Some construction kicking off this morning at 9 o'clock along Long Lake, both directions between Crooks and Livernois. That will be closed. Now, WJR Weather First from the Weather Channel, sponsored by the Cremation Society of Michigan. For over 32 years, the Cremation Society of Michigan has been providing dignified cremation services without the cost of traditional funerals. For cremation information, contact the Cremation Society of Michigan at 1-800-241-3131 or visit cremationmichigan.com. Great day ahead. Some clouds, some sun mixed in. We stay dry throughout the weekend, a high of 82. Tonight, partly cloudy, low 64. Friday, some clouds, some sun once again, and a high of 83. Cloudy skies, 74 degrees. I'm Dana Clark, WJR News, with Dick Hafner in about 1 minute.
So here's some good news about coronavirus.
Oh, good.
Mosquitoes cannot spread it.
Oh, that's good.
They're still a pain in the...
Oh, man.
Are they like extra hungry right now.
Yeah.
I think.
I'm thinking of buying...
I had Rose out. I've done a lot of things, but it's overwhelming, the number of mosquitoes. I'm thinking of buying one of those things.
Dynatrap? I have one. I like it.
Wait, what is that?
It's called a Dynatrap.
I got one of these. This one.
You might have a different one.
Well, this one, it's from the Hammacher Schlemmer catalog. Don't you love that catalog?
Oh, never heard of it.
America's longest running catalog. 172 years.
Really? Wow.
Yeah. But it's not, it might not be the best place to buy stuff pricing wise, but it gives you an idea. So I would look for this. They don't put a brand name. Oh yeah. It's Dynatrap.
Dynatrap. QVC.
That's what Dana has.
1 acre backyard mosquito trap. You have the Dynatrap, did you say?
Yes.
And it's this decorative mosquito trap captures and kills insects over a 1 acre area without harmful chemicals. It lures mosquitoes with carbon dioxide and UV light, traps them in a removable compartment where they die of dehydration. Yes,
love it, love it, love it, love it. Yeah. And it works. So QVC, it's though.
Little, you did it where?
QVC.
Where'd you buy it? QVC? QVC. I haven't heard those. You know,
really?
They were right out of Philadelphia. QVC was right there. Mm-hmm. I went to their studios. I used to work on a channel in New York City that sold stuff. We would go on the air at 11 o'clock at night. And for 2 hours, I would sell stuff on camera. And this is before these channels
QVC-ish.
Became.
Yeah.
It was totally. What was the other one? QVC and.
HSN.
What was it? Home Shopping Network. All right. Yeah. So Home Shopping Network and QVC were not yet born when I did this thing in New York.
Wow.
And it came about because a guy had a big warehouse, and he had a bunch of stuff in the warehouse and he wanted to get rid of it. And it was stuff like watches. And the one I remember a lot, Capodimonte, like statues and kind of earthenware. Capodimonte, I think is what it was, like artsy stuff and a whole bunch of other stuff. And it really went well. We were selling like crazy, and the two partners got into a fight because the one guy had vision and said, hey, this is really working. We need to start offering other products. We need to start offering other stuff. We can get it wholesale from wherever and sell it, and we're going to be rich. And the other guy said, no, I'm only doing this to clear out my warehouse. I don't want to get a bunch of other stuff. I want to clear out my warehouse. And that's what ended. What could have been, it would have made them billionaires. Mm-hmm. And who knows? I might still be on television.
You might.
Is that the same manicures model?
And everything?
Is that the same model as what Marty does, Marty Hornacek, where they have all this product?
Well, he certainly, yeah. You know what Marty does, and maybe he can explain it. Although he told me on the phone yesterday, because Marty Hornacek from Northwoods Wholesale, is going to be on today. What a couple of stories he has. First of all, it's hard to get product. He's having a hard time getting any product.
Very hard.
So what Marty's, the way he explained it to us when we all went in there and saw it and did the tour, is trucks go in and deliver things to places. And oftentimes the trucks have more material than the place they're delivering to can use. And so now all of a sudden, this guy's got a quarter of a truck of material, and what's he going to do with it? Well, people now know that people like Marty, for example, will buy basically whatever you've got on that truck as long as I get a deal on it. So he sells things, name brand things. Speaking of dark chocolate, Ghirardelli chocolate. Mountains of it.
Yeah.
Because he got, you know, somebody's extra truckload of it. And if it costs $9 in a store, he's got it for a dollar. I mean, it's astonishing his pricing. But that is kind of the way he does it. You know, by making it well known through the industry that if you have extra widgets, he'll take them as long as he can get them at an incredibly good price. And he does. Love that place. I just got a text. I almost said call because it's like a text is like a call anymore. You know, when you say, well, I spoke to so-and-so, and you say, well, did you really talk to him? Well, we texted back and forth.
Exactly.
I mean, that's the new way. That's the new I talked to. So I talked to Jim Miller, a guy I worked with starting out at my first radio station, WVMO in Monroe, when I was in high school, 15 years old, the voice of Monroe, WVMO. And he was the wise older guy. Jim Miller just sent me a note saying, hey, I went to Northwoods Wholesale. What a place. I mean, you can't go there without reacting that way. It's overwhelming.
It's worth a visit. Maybe he has a Dynatrap.
He does? Oh. Do you think he does? Maybe he does. I'm going to ask him, and I'll buy it. I bought a Weber grill from him.
Yeah, he might, because they're very popular. You can get it on Amazon too. So he probably has one.
Well, that's where I'll buy it because I guarantee it'd be the best price.
Doesn't he also take products? So isn't there some kind of a rule or law if one box of Cheez-Its is damaged, then the whole pallet has to be?
I don't know.
I wouldn't be surprised. It feels like that, you know, where they take the whole palette.
Paul W. Smith Show, News Talk 760.
I cleaned out my sinuses when that blast came out. Good Thursday morning to you. It's July 23rd, the 205th day of 2020. There are 161 days left in the year. Make each and every day count. Each day is a gift. We're happy to be with you on this Thursday, or as Dana would say, Friday Eve. Anna's signed on for that one as well. It's Friday Eve. We've got an entire show planned for you. We've got news, weather, sports, traffic information that you can use. And we'll keep you entertained along the way as well with the team, our news director, Dick Hafner, presenting the news. As news, believe it or not, rather than opinion. Dana Clark has an opinion or two, but you know when she's delivering the traffic and weather, she's giving you the facts that you need to know to get you around any problems that might be out there. Brian Morton pressing all the right buttons in the Golden Tower of the Fisher Building, the only one there. The rest of us are home and getting pretty comfortable doing it from home. And Kim is up, no longer toes up. And, of course, Ann Thomas, our executive producer, handling this one, two, three, four, five, six, ring circus.
Good morning, Dub.
Good morning, Annie. So we were talking about mosquito traps, and I'm going to ask Marty Hornacek if he has the Dyna trap that Dana has. It works pretty well, Dana?
Works amazing. And at the end of the season, when you do dump it out, you can't believe how much is in there. Because it catches other things too, other bugs, flies.
Maybe you should take it to the lake and dump it in for the fish.
Yeah. Oh, okay. I need to
Now we're probably polluting the lake with dead flies. I don't really know. So, as much as we might long to be able to get away from it all, there's no place to go. Although I did see an ad for Bermuda. Did they say they were virus free?
Can we go there?
Definitely promoting a visit there.
They haven't locked us out like the Bahamas?
No, it doesn't sound like they have.
No,
Sounds like they're welcoming us with open arms.
Yeah.
And without fear, a major fear of the virus. I love Bermuda. Haven't been there in a very long time. It's a fabulous little island.
I've not been
there. One time, it
cruise
lines
are also lining up cruises to Bermuda.
Oh,
are they?
Cruise.
I was just about to say that cruise lines, I love cruise lines. I know you don't, Dana, but I love cruise lines.
Me too.
But I must say, I wish cruise lines never discovered places like Bermuda, because frankly, a quaint little island that you can walk around and feel like you're on a quaint little island changes tremendously when, in effect, three cities have pulled up to the docks and emptied out thousands of people to come through the island changes everything.
It does.
It sure does. So here's what my point was. Apparently, in Venice, which has never been really lately open to tourism because they feel that we're ruining their lives, but we have to point out to them they couldn't have lived without tourism for a very long time. But anyway, there's a new restriction on gondolas.
Isn't this funny? I love this.
There used to be, you could have six passengers on gondolas for the guys with the sticks, you know, the poles, and they go, oh, Solomon, you know. Now it's five. Anybody know why? Anne does.
I won't say why.
It's not about social distancing.
The driver makes six?
Over the last 10 years, they say, we've gotten fatter. So rather than have to weigh everybody before they get on the gondola. Sorry, would you step on the scale over here? Would you step on the scale? It makes sense. Rather than have everyone step on a scale, just cut one person. Say, no longer can you have six. It's got to be five.
I can see that.
And wait a minute. Why
it's
is it
supposed to be a gondola, not whaling?
That's right. What do they think they have on there? Airline seats? Because airline seats have gotten thinner as we haven't gotten thinner, it seems. By the way, for our friends in Ohio, when we were talking about our Governor Whitmer having an op-ed piece in the New York Times about getting the president to do a federal mandate to wear masks. Guess what? Well, we have one in Michigan. But now, today, the Ohio mask mandate goes into effect.
Yes.
So they've gone a long time without having to wear a mask, and now they have to. So we can see how much foolishness happens there with people saying, I don't have to wear, I'm not wearing a mask. I will not wear a mask. I did see a note, sadly, someone sent it along to me, probably Art Volo, anything radio related. A guy I used to work for in Toledo, Ohio, named Frazier Reams Jr. He owned a lot of stations, WIOT and WCWA in Toledo. I think Mike Wheeler might have worked at WIOT, our current program operations director, our fine program manager. But I worked at WCWA, and a few years ago, John Federke, dear, dear friend, John Federke, asked me to come into the Toledo Exchange Club. And I think I was maybe introducing or speaking along with, I can't remember, PJ O'Rourke. I don't know if you remember any of this, Ann, but
I do, yes.
A number of years ago. And when I came there and I spoke and I talked fondly of my time in Toledo, when I was done, Fraser Reams came up to me and said hello. And I immediately felt bad because I didn't say when I was addressing this crowd, oh, I had fond memories of working for Fraser Reams and all that. I didn't know he was still alive. And unfortunately, he no longer is now. This lawyer, former state senator, radio station owner, has passed away at the age of 91. And we send our thoughts and prayers to his lovely wife, Susan, and to the Fraser Reams family. He was a really, you know what? His wife said it, and it's true. I wish somebody could say it of me, but they can't. And that is, he was always happy.
That's a nice thing, yeah.
I can't say that about a lot of people, but we can say it about Fraser Reams. Think about that. How many people can you say that they were always happy? And Fraser Reams was. God bless him. Very philanthropic, too. It is 6:14 at WJR.
This report is sponsored by ExpressPros.com. Mark your calendars. Express Employment Professionals is once again hosting National Interview Day on August 6th. This special event supports hiring as businesses continue to reopen and business ramps back up. Apply online today. Visit ExpressPros.com/interviewday to find a location near you.
6:14, our WJR traffic and weather first, Miss Dana Clark.
Traffic First, also sponsored by the Carpenters Labor Management Partnership Team. Hire the Carpenter LMPT contractors for your next construction project. Their workforce is the best in Michigan. Professional, safety conscious, and craft trained for every project. Hire the Carpenters LMPT contractors today. Call 877-477-LMPT. That's 877-47-LMPT. Roadways looking good, kicking off at 9 o'clock today. Long Lake, both directions will shut down between Crooks and Livernois. That's for a construction. Now, WJR Weather First from the Weather Channel, sponsored by the Restore Wellness Center. Tired of dealing with nagging body pain? The Restore Wellness Center will reduce the pain and scar tissue, improve blood flow, nerve function, and muscle stimulation. The state's best non-invasive laser therapy treatments will reduce your pain. Call 800-935-5959 in Brighton, Shelby, and Bloomfield, or RestoreWellnessCenter.com.
Seasonably warm here today. Mix of clouds and sun. Mid-80s this afternoon. Mid-60s tonight. Sunny tomorrow. Low to mid-80s on Friday. Warmer for the weekend. Mix of clouds and sun. Mid-upper 80s Saturday. Back to around 90s Sunday. From the Weather Channel, I'm meteorologist Ken Boone on News Talk 760 WJR.